Good morning, my dear students. Today we are discussing about Geography Unit 1 Marking Question and Answers. Now I give book back question and answers. Students, take your social science book, page number 165. Roman letter 1, choose the correct answer. First question. Dust is the rigid outer layer of the earth. Option A, core. Option B, mantle. Option C, crust. Option D, inner core. Which one is the correct answer? Option C, crust is the correct answer. Okay, second question. Dust layer is made up of liquid iron. Option A, inner core. Option B, outer core. Option C, mantle. Option D, crust. Which one is the correct answer? Option B, outer core is the correct answer. Third question. Magma is found in the dust. Option A, crust. Option B, mantle. Option C, core. Option D, none of the above. Which one is the correct answer? B. Option B, mantle is the correct answer. Fourth question. Dioscorism is connected to dust. Option A, volcanism. Option B, earthquakes. Option C, tectonics. Option D, fold or fault. Which one is the correct answer? D, fold or fault is the correct answer. Next, fifth question. The movement of tectonic plates is induced by dust energy. Option A, hydel. Option B, thermal. Option C, wave. Option D, tidal. Which one is the correct answer? Option B, thermal is the correct answer. Sixth question. In the ancient period, Gondwana land moved towards this direction. Option A, north. Option B, south. Option C, east. Option D, west. Which one is the correct answer? Option A, north is the correct answer. Next, seventh question. Many million years ago, India was a part of the supercontinent. Das. Option A, Gondwana. Option B, Laurasia. Option C, Pandalasa. Option D, Pangaea. Which one is the correct answer? Option A, Gondwana is the correct answer. Eighth question. The movement of plates that creates stress and tension in the rocks causing them to stretch and cracks result in dust. Option A, fold. Option B, fault. Option C, mountain. Option D, earthquake. Which one is the correct answer? Fault is the correct answer. Option B, fault is the correct answer. Ninth question. Dust refers to a bowl-shaped depression found at the top of the volcano. Option A, crater. Option B, vent. Option C, chamber. Option D, volcanic cone. Which one is the correct answer? Option A, crater is the correct answer. Tenth question. The point of origin of an earthquake is called the dust. Option A, epicenter. Option B, focus. Option C, seismic wave. Option D, magnitude. Which one is the correct answer? Option B, focus is the correct answer. Next, Roman letters again. Match the following. First question, endogenetic process. Answer, volcanic eruption. Students, in your book, eruption is missing. Add please, volcanic eruption. Okay. Next, second question, mantle. Mantle. Answer, sima. Third one, convergent boundaries. Answer, subduction zone. Fourth one, earthquake. Answer, seismograph. Fifth one, composite volcano. Answer, Pacific Ocean. Okay. Third Roman letter. Consider the given statements. First question. Roman letter 1. Mount Fuji is a dormant volcano. Second point. Mount Kilimanjaro is a dormant volcano. Third statement. Mount Tanzania is a dormant volcano. Which is the statement are true? Option A. One is true. Option B. Second is true. Option C. Third is true. Option D, 1, 2, 3 are true. Which one is the correct answer? Option A, 1 is correct. That means, option 1 is, Mount Fuji is a dormant volcano is the correct answer. Second question, statement. Magma gushes out when it finds vents. Reason, interior of the earth contains compressed hot magma. Which of the statements are true? Option A, statements and reason are true. Option B, statement is true, reason is false. Option C, statement is false, reason is true. Option D, statement and reason are false. Which one is the correct answer? Option A, statements and reason are true. Third question, statement 1. Mountain ranges are formed by the collisions of tectonic plates. Statement 2, the movement of tectonic plates is due to the thermal energy from the mantle. Option A, statement 1 is false, second is true. Option B, statement 1 and 2 are false. Statement, option C, statement 1 is true, second is false. Option D, statement 1 and 2 are true. Next, Roman letter 4. Answer in brief. First question, write a brief note on the various spheres of the earth. Page number 158, page number 158, top of the page, left side, four spheres have, students, four spheres have the top of the page. The four spheres, atmosphere, hydrosphere, biosphere and lithosphere, the four spheres fully. That is, short answer 1, the 4 points, okay, that is short answer 1. Second question, mention the layers of the interior of the earth, page number 157. Page number 157, right side page, sequence 1.2, heading structure of the earth, third line, from third line to the that paragraph fully. From third line, the structure of the earth interior is divided into 3 layers, namely the crust, mantle, core. That's all. This question number 2. Next, third question, define plate tectonics, page number 160. Students, take page number 160, right side, topic plate tectonics, fifth line, from fifth line to ninth line, plate tectonics, fifth line the collisions, fifth line from collisions to the ninth line, plate tectonics, see fifth line. Collisions of these plates produce mountain ranges and other irregular surface features both on land and the ocean floor. This phenomenon is called plate tectonics. This is question number 3. Next, question number 4. What is tsunami? Answer, page number 162. Students, take page number 162 page, right side, the bottom of the page, tsunami, heading tsunami, first word, the tsunami, the word tsunami is a Japanese term meaning harbor waves. It is adapted to describe large seismically generated sea waves caused by earthquakes, submarine explosion and landslides. That's all. Okay. So, tsunami question, page number 162, top of the bottom of the page, heading tsunami, first line to page number 163, left side, first 3 lines up to landslides. This question number 4. Next question. Question 5. What is volcano? What is a volcano? Mention its major components. Page number 163. Students, take page number 163. Left side. Volcanoes heading from first line to a volcano to fifth line interior. This is fifth question. First line, a volcano is a vent or an opening on the surface of the earth crust through which hot, solid, liquid and gaseous materials, magma, erupt out to the surface from the earth interior. This is fifth question. Next short answer, sixth. Sixth short answer, what's an earthquake? And how it is occurs? Page number 162. Students, take page number 162. Left side, earthquake heading. From first line to up to fourth line, disturbances. From first line earthquakes to up to fourth line disturbance. This is question number 6. Okay. Next, seventh question. What are seismic waves and mention its types? Page number 162. Students, take 162. Right side, top of the page, heading seismic waves. The seismic waves headings, the seismic waves paragraph fully. And mention it layers. Mention it types. What types? First types, primary or P waves. Okay. Students, underline the types, primary or P waves. Second types, secondary or S waves. Third types, surface waves or L waves. That's all. This is question number 7. Next, 8th question. Write about the Pacific Ring of Fire. Page number 164. Students, take page number 164. Right side, third line, the ring of fire. The ring of fire is the most seismically and volcanically active zone in the world. The other distinctive major belts are mid-Atlantic ridges, mid-continental belts and alpine Himalayan belt. This is 8th question. Next, Roman letter 5. Give reason for the following. First question, Seal floats over Sima. Answer. First point, Seal consists of silica and aluminium. Second point, Sima consists of silica and magnesium. Third point, Seal is lighter than Sima. Therefore, Seal floats over Sima. Student, take on screenshot to this page because it's useful for your studies. Second question. Igneous rocks are called primary rocks or mother rocks. Answer. Igneous rocks are also called primary rocks or mother rocks because all other rocks are directly or indirectly formed from igneous rocks. Okay, sixth Roman letter, distinguish between, first question, core and crust, first point, core, the first point, the core is the innermost hottest layer of the earth and true center. The crust is the outer layer of the earth. Second point, core. It is the composed mainly of nickel and iron. So it is termed as nice. Core. Second point. It is composed of silica and aluminium. So it is termed as Cl. Third point. Denser materials exist within Earth's core.
crust. Third point, lighter material exists on the surface. Okay, second question. Students, the first question, the distinguish between the core and the crust, both 2 point only enough. Okay, next, second question, epicenter and hypocenter. First point, epicenter is a point on the earth's surface that lies directly above the focus. Hypocenter, first point, it is a point within the earth when an earthquake and rupture starts. Epicenter, second point, the impact of the earthquake is felt the most at the center. Hypocenter, second point, it generates series of elastic waves. Okay, third question, divergent and convergent boundaries. Book page number 160, right side, topic, types of plate boundaries topics. Have two types of boundaries, do you know? Convergent boundary and divergent boundary. Convergent boundary, first point, here the plates to up to the subduction zone. Okay. Divergent boundary, the first line, here the plates to up to pushes up from the mantle. Okay. And convergent boundary, second point, example, fold mountain Himalayas. Then divergent boundary, example, mid-Atlantic ridges. Okay. This is third question, distinguish between convergent boundary and divergent boundary. Okay. Fourth question, primary waves and secondary waves. Primary waves, first point, these waves are the fastest of all the earthquake waves and the first to reach the epicenter. Primary waves, these waves are fastest of all the earthquake waves and the first to reach the epicenter. Secondary waves, first point, secondary waves travel less faster than the primary waves. Next, second point, primary waves are second points. These waves pass through solids, liquids and gases. Secondary waves, second points. These waves travel only through solids. Primary waves. Third point. The average velocity of this wave is 5.3 km to 5.3 km to 10.6 km per second. Secondary waves. Third point. The average velocity of this wave is 1 kilometer to 8 kilometer per second. Okay. Next, fifth question. Shield volcano or volcanic dome? Shield volcano, first question. Shield volcano are formed by intense viscous lava. Volcanic dome. Right side part. A lava dome or volcanic dome is a roughly circular mound formed due to the slow ejection of viscous lava from the volcano. Next, second point. Shield volcano, second point. As the lava is rich in silica with intense viscosity, it is prevented from flowing far from its vent. For example, Paracatin, Mexico. Volcanic dome, second point. These are shallow deposition with gently sloping sides. Hence, the lava flows out in all the directions to create a shield. For example, Mauna Loa in Hawaii. Okay. Roman letter 7. Write answers in a paragraph. First question. Describe the structure of the earth. Page number 157. 158.
Students take page number 157. Sequence 1.2, structure of the heading, structure of the earth. From third line the structure to core, up to core. Okay, the structure of the earth interior is divided into three layers, namely crust, mantle, core. Okay, next page number 158, left side, the heading crust heading fully. Next, page number 159, mantle heading fully. Next, core heading, first line the core, from core to 8th line, earth's gravitational force, up to earth's gravitational force. That's all, this paragraph 1. Second question, write a note on internal and external process of earth. Page number 160. Students, take 160. Page number 160. Left side, sequence 1.4, geomorphic processes. The first paragraph, internal process, then second paragraph, external process. Okay, second paragraph, page number 160, the top of the page, first three lines, up to endogenetic processes. This paragraph 2. Okay, next, third paragraph, how are volcanoes classified based on the periodicity of their eruptions? Page number 163, 164. Students, take page number 163, right side, top of the page, the based on the periodicity of eruptions, volcanoes are classified into active volcano, dormant volcano, extinct volcano. Okay, next, the three volcanoes, explain these three volcanoes, active volcano fully, dormant volcano fully, and extinct or dead volcano fully. That's all, up to page number 164, up to Tamil Nadu. Okay, first three lines, up to Tamil Nadu. This paragraph 3. Fourth paragraph, page number 164. Fourth paragraph, explain the effects of volcanoes. Page number 164, right side, effect of volcanoes, constructive effects and destructive effects fully, up to region. This is paragraph 4. Okay, next, Roman letter 8, map skill. On the given outline map of the world, mark the following. First one, Pacific Ring of Fire. Students, see the map, all of you. Pacific Ring of Fire. Second place, earthquake prone zones. Any two earthquake prone zones. See, what are they? Two earthquake prone zone. Students, one, China and Vietnam. Okay. Third one, locate any two active volcanoes of the world. Active volcanoes, Japan. Okay, Fuji in Japan. Another one, Hawaii Island. Okay. Next, see, Hawaii Island. Next, Himalayas and Alpine Ranges. Himalayas and Alpine ranges. Next, Rift Valley of East Africa. Students, see Rift Valley of East Africa. Okay, this lesson is over. Students, listen here. All are take your diary or rough note. Note today's homework. Geography lesson 1. Give reasons questions and distinguish questions. Read thoroughly. Tomorrow I will conduct test. Okay, bye. We will meet next class. Thank you.